company.
Here they come! Come on, come on, come on, come on! Air slash! Yeah, ha! That was way too fast.
They're putting up more of a fight than we've...
Pathetic! Letting a couple of brats step all over us? Just wait till I show them!
We aren't just any brats, I'll have you know. We're the official town defense force! And we're not about to let some punk swagger in here with his pack of gutless losers.
Yeah, you guys wouldn't last 2 minutes in a fight.
What did you say?
Let's get him, boss!
We got trouble! This looks tough! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Boy,
wish they could have lasted longer! All right!
Oh, great!
The power's flowing in me!
Whew! Thanks a lot, guys!
Just doing our job, sir.
Ooh, how suave of you.
I made some tea for you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Enjoy.
Those bandits hardly even put up a fight.
What are you talking about? That was a pretty close call and you know it. Something wrong, Roddick? You look a little off.
Oh, he's just been moping around all the time lately.
Well, see you later.
Yeah.
Hope you feel better tomorrow, Roddick. Thanks again, ma'am.
Oh, certainly. Come back anytime.
Being bored's a good thing, huh?
Oh, I thought you were still sleeping. Did you have trouble falling asleep?
No, I'm fine.
Are you sure? You've been acting kind of strange lately. I don't want Millie and Dorn having to worry about you.
Oh, stop worrying so much, Mom. I'll be back later.
Good morning, Roddick. Dorn already went inside.
Hey, Roddick. The captain's waiting for you.
to business, then. You made us all proud here yesterday, repelling a bandit warlord with only the three of you, they tell me. The townspeople wanted me to give this to you. Here, take it.
Yo, Gregory, things feel like a shit, man.
What the? Hey, this is Roddick's favorite food. Why does he get special treatment?
It came from a fan of Roddick's. That's all I know. Well, regardless, keep up the good work, all of you.
It's not like we get stuff like we had yesterday very often. This town be perfectly safe even if we sat on our tails all day.
Dorn, knock it off.
You called for us, sir?
Ah, Roddick. Good to see you here. We've got trouble. Take a look at this. A letter came in earlier.
Send help immediately. Mystery outbreak in Cool Village. Residents suffering from high fever. Mayor, Cool Village.
So what do?
We go help them out, that's what!
The herbs that grow on the peak of Mount Matorx ought to do the trick.
Wait!
Father!
Leave this matter to me.
Martoth, will you go on our behalf?
Yes, I don't think we have much to worry about with this mystery outbreak.
Well, if the best healer in all of Kratos is on the job, it'd be a tremendous relief to all of us.
I'll be back in a little while, all right? Stay away from Mount Matorx. It's too dangerous for you.
I'm off. Have a good night.
Yes, sir. We'll let you know if anything's up. Come on, guys. Lighten up a bit. Millie, I know how you feel, but Roddick, you've been acting weird lately. What's wrong? You can tell us.
Still hasn't come back. I've got to find him.
You're not going, all right? He said he'd call us if he needed us.
But I can't just sit around and wait anymore.
Roddick! What's it say?
A powerful disease has struck Kool. My methods are powerless against it, and even worse. I'm afraid I've contracted the disease myself. Casual skin contact is enough to spread the illness. It incubates for about an hour, but after it develops, the infected turn into stone in about 3 days' time. There is no hope for Kool. Do not approach it under any circumstances. Martarth Kliet.
Millie, wait! She's gonna head for Kool all by herself. We've gotta stop her.
What's wrong, Dorne?
Nothing. It's nothing. Millie! After her!
Stay away from me! No matter what you do, don't touch me!
Father...
I am done for, Millie.
And you won't let me sit by your side, Father? I can't even hold your hand? Something like this happened!
Roddick, Dorn, can you take my daughter back to town for me?
Millie, let's go.
Millie!
I'm sorry, guys.
Wait!
Dorn?
Planning to go off by yourself? You're going to pick some herbs off the peak of Mount Matorx, aren't you? Doesn't take a genius to see what you're thinking. But listen, you can't go into that hornet's nest. Not by yourself.
I'm sorry.
Come on, quit pouting.
Huh?
It'll be okay. Your dad'll be fine once we get those herbs.
Yeah. But...
This is terrible. I can't stand seeing you sad like this.
Dorn?
Millie, I want you to know something. I...
Dorn? what's wrong? Are you all right?
Get away from me! No, sorry. I'm fine. It's nothing.
But you're... Hold tight just a minute. I'll go find someone. Roddick, Dorn just collapsed.
Every time something comes up, what's the first thing out of her mouth? Roddick. Roddick.
Roddick, come with me. Dorn's in trouble.
Right, let's go.
Are you all right?
Huh? What do you mean?
But I just saw you...
Stop jumping to conclusions. I was just a little lightheaded, that's all. I told you it was nothing. Roddick, don't you think we ought to go pick some herbs at the peak of Mount Matorx? That ought to be just the thing for Millie's dad.
Yeah. Matorx lies due north of Kool. We'll need to watch ourselves.
You said it. That's Fellworm territory up there.
Let's go!
Everyone ready?
Ha!
Yeah!
Ha! Ha!
That one was way easy. Too fast! Look out!
We have company.
Ha! 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 Yeah!
That one was easy.
It's over?
The power's flowing in me!
This looks bad.
We got trouble.
Ha! Ha!
That one was easy.
It's over?
focused, everyone! We got trouble! Ha! Ha! Take this! Ha! 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 Yeah! Ha! Take this! Ha! Ha! Ha!
This one
could have lasted long. The power's flowing in me! Focused, everyone!
We can't lose this!
Ha! Ha!
Guess
huh?
It's over!
It's over?
All
the
right.
Power's flowing in me!
You alright?
Don't touch me!
What? I'm just worried about you! You don't have to yell at me like that.
No, it's nothing. Don't worry about me.
Wait, you didn't catch the...
I must have caught it when I touched that carrier pigeon.
Oh no!
We better go back home.
No, I'm fine. I haven't started turning into stone yet.
But...
I said I'm fine! I'm sorry, but I'm fine, really. Besides, those herbs will cure me anyway, right? Let's get moving.
There's the flower that we need.
Thought there wasn't supposed to be anyone here.
There weren't any life forms here, Captain, when I scanned the area.
Who are you? What do you want?
Have you come here to take the herbs away from us?
Where did you come from?
Look, you don't have to be so...
Stay where you are!
So afraid. That didn't work.
Who are you? Where are you from? You're dressed really weird and I don't trust you!
Well, you see, my name is Ronix J. Kenny. How can I explain this so it makes sense?
Captain,
huh?
Allow me. My name's Elia Silvestri, and please, before you say anything, I want you to know that we're not your enemy. We're here to help you.
Huh?
Before you say anything, I want to let you know that we are not your enemy.
Really?
Well, they sure aren't our friends. Not these strangers.
We're here to pick some of the herbs off of this mountain, that's all.
I should tell you that these herbs won't stop anyone from turning into stone.
How? Who are you?
More interested in listening to us now?
All right, go.
I'm sure you won't believe us at first, but we've come from a place far, far away to save all of you.
So why didn't you come sooner then?
We can't make direct contact with civilizations in the early stages of development. It's part of the Underdeveloped Planet Preservation Pact.
Early stages of development?
We came here from beyond the sky, from another planet. We're making something of a special exception to the rule, you see.
Beyond the sky? Another planet?
Are you gods?
No, we're not gods. We're people, just like you. Well, except without the tails.
Oh, wow!
Lazonia, a force opposing our own, broke the underdeveloped planet preservation pact recently, and engaged in direct interference with this planet. As if that weren't bad enough, they also fired a biological weapon at you, releasing the contagion that spread across this whole area.
So we're turning into stone, and it's because of those Lazonia guys?
Correct.
I can't believe this!
We've been sent here to examine the disease and try to find a treatment for it.
So you see, we've come here to help you. Probably in ways you've never imagined.
I still can't believe any of this. But can you really help with the cure?
I can't really believe it either. But if you're able to save our friend here...
If you come with us and help us in creating a vaccine, we should be able to cure him.
Vaccine?
A miracle medicine, sort of.
Well then, there's something you ought to know before we go any further. If you folks decide to come with us, you'll probably never see this planet again.
Why not?
That's what the rules say. If you interact with us too much, we can't let you go back to your original life. That's another part of the underdeveloped planet preservation pact. Now, if you'd like, we could go our separate ways, and you could pretend this was all some kind of fever dream. There is still time for that.
Well, I'm going with these guys. All I've got waiting for me here is life as a statue.
You can't do that! You want me to choose between losing you forever or losing my father and everyone else forever? Don't make me do that, Dorn!
Millie, let's go with Dorn, too. I'm sorry to break this to you, but there's just nothing we can do if we stay here. I know it's hard leaving everyone you know in Kratos, but we've got a bigger job ahead. We're going to save everybody.
Well, it's settled then. Might as well get going. Close your eyes for a moment, please.
Where are we?
This is our ship.
You really are gods.
We're not gods. We've just advanced a little sooner than you, that's all. You can have all this for yourselves too someday.
Well, let's get him over to sickbay.
The floor. It's moving.
And that door back there opened by itself.
Incredible. I've never seen anything like this before.
I just realized, I haven't asked any of your names yet.
My name is Roddick Ference.
I'm Millie Cliette.
Dorn... Myrtle...
Captain, his condition's deteriorating.
Better hurry then.
What's this?
I guess this must be surprising to you, but this is how we treat sick people.
See what you can do for him, Doctor.
Yes, sir.
Well, Noble.
Captain, that would be a violation of the Preservation Pact.
Well, it's a little late for that, isn't it? I'll be on the bridge. You show him around for me. Okay?
Captain! Watch out! The sensors are detecting an alien presence.
Must have latched onto us at Mount Matorx. Let's get him, Millie!
This looks bad.
This looks tough! Ha! Ha!
Boy, huh? They were
it's
weak!
Over?
It's gone!
Huh? isn't? See? It's right here.
You can still see it? The moment your blood touched it, it disappeared.
Ilya, take Roddick and Millie to sick bay. I'll meet you there.
Yes, sir.
Wait, where did that come from just now?
We have these things called communicators. They let us talk to people even if we're far away from each other. Anyway, the doctor wants to see us. Let's head to sick bay. I'll get someone to clean up this mess.
Is he cured?
I don't know yet.
Well, how is he?
Don't be in such a hurry there, miss. The doctor's just getting to that.
Ahem. After a thorough investigation, I have isolated and analyzed the pathogen behind the disease. I'm afraid curing this illness is something that's beyond the ability of Earth medical science.
But you've got all these amazing things! Can't you do something? Anything?
The advanced medical technology at my fingertips is precisely what allows me to declare that this is an impossible task, young lady. This pathogen is in a constant state of flux, mutating at a truly breathtaking speed. Even if I could make a vaccine, it would lose its effectiveness in a matter of minutes. There is one possible method, however. Judging by the pathogen structure, I believe this to be a naturally occurring virus. So if we could track down the host, the original carrier of the disease, we could use the host's blood to create an immunity serum.
So that'll work! I mean, would that work, sir?
I believe so.
But he'll be turning into stone within 3 days. That's nowhere near enough time to find the host.
Oddly enough, the body's molecular structure seems to remain perfectly intact, even after the petrification process is complete. If we could just
Well, that's something to work with anyway.
It won't be easy, though. I doubt Lazonia is that eager to tell us where the host is.
You're right. More importantly, though, I can't help but wonder, why did they even use this bioweapon on Planet Roke in the first place?
Roke?
The name we've given your homeworld. But Ilya's right. I don't see how Lazonia benefits at all from turning everyone on Roke into stone.
Doctor, are there any major differences between the anatomy of Rokians and other humanoid species on other planets?
Well, let me think.
Their blood?
Precisely. The structure of their blood vastly differs from our own. The most obvious point is the hemoglobin. In humans, it is iron-based, but in Rokians, it is copper-based.
What are you getting at, Ilya?
This is just a possibility, but perhaps there is some benefit to petrifying the Rokians after all. That would explain the motive behind dropping this bioweapon on their planet.
What kind of benefit?
Some kind of previously undiscovered matter, maybe.
You mean what?
There is that possibility. In particular, I'm talking about something that's invisible. Something that wouldn't even show up on our sensors.
So they're killing us off to make some kind of weapon for themselves?
Well, we can't say that for sure yet.
It would certainly explain a lot of things, though.
If that's the case, then they must be removing the petrified bodies from Roke. Let's check that prospect out first. I'll be on the bridge.
Doctor,
Run a simulation to see if petrifying their blood results in some sort of matter that can be used for offensive purposes.
Are you sure? We're talking tens of thousands of combinations.
Yo. No.
There's no other way.
This is
You've
first
got
departure.
To find out.
PSP.
Very well.
Yeah, dude, this is that would be like 3D, dude.
This is what
2D.
I get for whining about how boring every day was.
What are you
yeah,
talking
this
about?
Is first departure,
you know this
dude.
Isn't your fault.
The guy that you're talking about, I think, is someone else.
I
already
know.
Played it and beat it.
I mean, look at me.
On stream.
If I just.
I'm just doing it again.
The captain wants you on the bridge. You can take the elevator.
Yeah,
and get there.
What's going on, man?
Thank you.
Ah, there you are. Elia has news for you.
We compared the current number of petrified bodies with our previous figures. The number's gone down by about 200,000. How did they take all of them off the planet without us noticing?
I fell asleep last night early, so my bad.
So yeah. It's true.
We're not yet sure if they're building a weapon.
It sure is hard to imagine those bodies being used for peaceful purposes at this point. Sorry. That, didn't come out right. By the way, we're returning to Earth. I'm going to go through our ambassadors and get Lazonia to hand over the host. Not that I expect them to be interested in negotiating with us in good faith. I'd like all of you to come with us and participate in the reports.
Captain, Dorne's condition is worsening.
I'll be right there. His vital organs have begun the petrification process. I'm afraid he's in critical condition.
Dorne.
Captain, there's something I want to ask you.
What is it?
If I'm going to die, I want it to happen in my own bed.
You're not gonna die. You'll just be asleep for a bit.
But what if you can't get that serum? Please.
All right. Get the transporter ready.
Yes, sir.
Please.
I don't know.
We'll come back. We promise.
All right. I'll have Elia accompany you then.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
I want Dorne transported directly into his bed, Doctor. This is a precision maneuver. Don't mess it up.
Yes, sir.
When you're ready, Elia.
Yes, Captain.
Listen. There was something I wanted to give you before I go.
Oh, don't say that. You'll just be sleeping for a little while.
Get the music box on that shelf for me. I'm giving that to you, Millie.
But this is your sister's. I can't take this.
Take it. What?
What? No.
I gave that to...
Your PlayStations?
It's all right. I swear we'll save you.
Oh, yeah. What about it? You could probably type it in your history, dude. Is it in your history? Is it in one of your bookmarks? Alright.
I know this is hard, but we've got to go.
Right.
Nice.
We'll be beginning our trip to planet Earth shortly. There's a room set up for you, so feel free to get some rest.
Thank you.
I remember you saying that you were doing that before.
Setting course for Sector Theta.
Mangrich did that. Mark 269, warp 6. Someone did that.
Look, Millie. It's magnificent.
What, a switch? They're coming out with a number 2. Did you know that? They're coming out with a number 2 switch.
It's like an ocean of stars.
You didn't know that?
We're now entering orbit to report to the Terran.
Nope, it's on the number 2.
Something's coming right for us!
Says it's gonna be for number 2 too.
Where? What are you talking about?
Dude, it's gonna be like console game. It's gonna be sick, dude.
Whoa, where did that come from? Did it warp in or? I don't think so, Captain. We did not detect any gravitational oscillation beforehand.
I told you it was coming.
You two were able to see it, Roddick? That's it.
You're lucky it's still there, dude.
Invisible matter.
The entire ship?
Captain, the unidentified ship that just appeared is hailing us.
Open a channel.
We come as emissaries from Lazonia. We have no desire to fight. Repeat.
No, I like
so
three people.
You're saying
people.
That Lazonia wants to sign an op.
That is correct.
Oh, in Discord? No,
we were
I thought
not
it was like
participants in the war.
I'm streaming too, dude.
The rumors of a third party.
Yeah, no, I was just being on myself, man. I was just chilling in here, dude.
A third party?
Yes, they had us at the points of their swords. Their civilization is highly advanced. They were the ones responsible for the destruction of planet Issei half a year earlier.
Yeah. That's what saving money out for, man, and taking them out to going somewhere is to
we have little idea what
the
their
days
goals
you miss them.
But they have provided us with a wealth of new technology.
I know
including
you know that
the
I'm saying those are the days that you can just recoup.
I think I understand what's happening.
Regarding the viral weapon that was dropped on planet Roke, we'd like you to provide us with either a vaccine or the original host of the disease, if you could.
I'm afraid we cannot. We know that the virus has its origins in the Asmodeus, a creature that lived on planet Roke 300 years ago.
Asmodeus? That's the Archfiend. The monster that was defeated in the demonic wars.
The stuff of legend, huh?
Neither the vaccine nor the host exist in this universe any longer. I'm afraid there is little we can do about Planet Roke.
No!
There's nothing to be done now. If there's no ready solution to the problem, we'll simply have to quarantine the planet Roke.
What? You want to just watch our planet die?
Roddick, calm down.
The hell with that? We've done so much. Traveled all this way to help out our friends.
And now what are we supposed to do?
Who would have imagined they got the virus off Roke 300 years ago, and just held it in storage all this time? There's no chance of host now. The Alliance has decided to seal off Roke forever. There's nothing we can do but apologize. I'm so sorry.
I thought you were gonna play Final Fantasy IX. I remember you saying that.
There is one chance. It's just extremely unlikely it will actually work.
You aren't actually suggesting we head for Planet Styx, are you? I should have known you'd bring that place up. You'd have to be crazy to suggest that.
I'll find a way to get us a ship.
But sir! There's still another option?
Well, I hesitate to call it that, but if we use the time gate on Planet Styx, there's a small chance. But Captain, you know the risks.
Please tell us, we've got to know.
I didn't hear any deployment orders, Captain.
Well, I have. Let us through.
Yes, sir.
All set here. Ready to go when you are, Captain.
Right. Close the entry hatch.
Are two people enough for this?
Oh, yeah. The computers do most of the work.
Computer?
Yeah. How to explain it. Basically, they're these tools that help people out with the difficult parts of their jobs. Anyway, let's get this thing off the ground.
You do realize, Captain, that going to Planet Styx is all but guaranteeing ourselves a court-martial.
Yep, worst case scenario, we'll all be in a labor camp for the rest of our lives, but too late to turn back now.
All the bad luck in the world, I get stuck with you for a commanding officer.
I'm sorry.
You don't have to apologize. I may have a ton of bad luck, but that doesn't mean I'm reluctant to visit Planet Styx. I'll follow wherever you go, Captain. Just try not to lead me astray, all right?
What is Planet Styx anyway?
the planet, just like Earth or Roke.
We stumbled upon it during an earlier deep space exploration mission.
They say that planet Styx was home to a vastly advanced civilization long before we humans even made it into space. Actually, we know next to nothing about them.
Nah, man, till the end of time, it's like almost like Star Ocean on the fourth point.
And that's where that time thing is?
Yeah.
The time gate. We'll use it to visit Roke in the past.
You know how it's real time in number four? You go in turn based, but then it goes into real time when you go into turn based. You know how like it goes like, you know how it like
it so if we
transitions
in time,
into the battle scenes
and,
like normally
in
number
need,
four?
Right?
Well, this one, it, like, turns over, like, it turning into the battle, like, it, like, does
in
that...
so many words,
that,
yes.
That scene, and then it goes right into the battle scene,
we
and then you move
haven't
around,
fully
run around, like,
how
tails,
the time gate
like,
works.
Tails games.
It's too dangerous to mess with, so it's been made strictly off-limits. We'll be within orbiting range of planet Styx shortly.
Right.
Will it let us in, though? The time gate, Guardian. The living gate.
According to the Lazonian emissaries, a mysterious third party obtained the virus on Roke.
Apparently, it all happened several hundred years ago.
That it did. The level of technology they have must outclass anything we could even imagine. We'll have to travel through time to a point before they visited Roke and collect a portion of the host's body.
Assuming, of course, the gate will let us through in the first place.
Guardian of the Time Gate, please lend an ear to our humble request. We seek your guidance to the world of 300 years past. We wish to visit Roke as it was in olden times.
I am the gatekeeper. Your request has been granted. Let us open the gate to the past.
We did it. We need to leave our weapons and communicators here before we enter. You bring them along, you'll bounce off the gate.
Well, here we go. I hope that we're not making a mistake by entering the gate, because once we go inside, there's no turning back. Thank you, Roddick.
Are you sure you're all right? We must hurry. The gate is...
Are you all right, Ilya?
Oh, yeah, I'm fine.
Where is everyone else? I don't see them anywhere. They should be around here.
Maybe. Then again, me tripping back there threw off our timing pretty badly. There's a chance we're a good distance away from each other.
Well, we picked a good place to appear. Let's go look for them in this village first.
Hang on. I just realized this outfit probably isn't gonna work here.
You're right. You'd stick out like a sore thumb. Why don't you wait here? I'll go...
Sorry for the trouble, but imagine what the captain must be
going through. Hey, Musa. Thanks for the like and share.
Well, good luck then.
Star Wars is only $3.99.
Ilya, I've got your clothes. Here you go.
Thanks. No peeking now. Sorry to complain, but this is way too loose. Well, I'll just go like this then.
Oh, are you...
Well, there's nothing else I can do. I can't change back into what I... Anyway, let's hurry. We need to stock up on supplies and run...
I'm not really sure what just happened here.
You.
Look out!
Oh, what a pain!
Here they come!
Word.
Well, I say, whoa!